The 1972 West Division race was all Chicago. The Blackhawks tied their all-time season high of 107 points with strong offense and awesome defense. Bobby and Dennis Hall terrorized goaltenders throughout the league with high-powered bombing leading to 50 and 30 goals, respectively. With Pitt Martin among the NHL's top 20, Stan Mikita, Jim Pappin, and Cliff Coral all enjoying productive campaigns, the Blackhawks' offense more than held its own. But it was an even greater year for the defense, as goaltenders Tony Esposito and Gary Smith captured the Vezina Trophy by a comfortable margin. Outstanding contributions from second-team All-Stars Bill White and Pat Stapleton helped cement the NHL's stingiest defense in front of the spectacular performance of Tony Esposito, the first-team All-Star goaltender. Improved team in the NHL, the Minnesota North Stars finished an easy second in the West with rugged defense and well-balanced offense. Jude Drouin, runner-up for the Calder Trophy in 1971, had an impressive sophomore season in spite of injuries that sidelined him for 15 games. Murray Oliver, Lou Nanny, Dean Prentice, and Danny Grant were solid performers all year long as Coach Jack Gordon's North Stars made the NHL take notice. Welcome addition to Minnesota was veteran Bob Nevin, acquired in an off-season trade with New York. Nevin's steadying two-way play was a major factor in the North Stars' surge. Bill Goldsworthy led all Minnesota scorers with his unique style of celebration and a 31-goal season, his third consecutive year of 30 or more. Although the attack was formidable, Minnesota's pride is defense. Ted Harris, Barry Gibbs, and Tom Reed provided the savvy and muscle, while netminders Cesar Maniago and Gump Worsley provided the acrobatics that led to a second-place finish in the Vezina Trophy race. The St. Louis Blues took third in the West behind the surprising play of rookie goaltender Jacques Caron. Caron came on strong in the second half of the season to lift the Blues into the playoffs after a dogfight that went down to the final weekend. Gary Unger topped all St. Louis scorers, finishing among the league's top 20 with 36 goals and 34 assists. He received strong support from Mike Murphy, Gary Sabourin, and Jack Egers, all with 20 goals or better on the year. Phil Roberto, obtained in a mid-season trade with Montreal, was another reason for the Blues' late-season rush, as was the consistent all-around play of Frank St. Marseille. The timeliest goal of the year came in overtime of the seventh game of first-round playoff competition. Kevin O'Shea's blistering slapshot eliminated the Minnesota North Stars and advanced the Blues into the Stanley Cup semifinals. Clinched the final West Division playoff spot on the last day of the season, following an incredible battle down the stretch. For the first time in their five-year history, the Penguins had 30 goals scored, as Jean Pronovost and Greg Poulos erased the former club mark of 26. Still Apps led all Pittsburgh point-getters with 59, while Brian Hextall, Ron Schock, and Bob Leader added scoring momentum in the fight for fourth place. Tim Horton anchored an improving backline with help from promising youngsters Darrell Edestrand and Dave Burrows. Jim Rutherford took charge in goal when the going got tough, and he did the job, including this stop that saved the entire season on the final weekend. The Philadelphia Flyers' year defied belief. Goalie Bruce Gamble suffered a heart attack in midseason. He recovered to attend Bruce Gamble Night at the Spectrum, but is permanently retired from hockey combat. Just prior to his illness, Gamble was playing the best hockey of his career and had won the number one job in goal for the Flyers. Doug Favell took over following Gamble's departure and went the rest of the season with virtually no relief help. The bright light for the Flyers was Bobby Clark. Clark broke all Philadelphia club records with 35 goals and 46 assists, good for 81 points and 10th place in the NHL scoring race. Second-year man Bob Kelly had another productive campaign for Philadelphia. Simon Ollais had his best season ever with 23 goals. And Gary Dornhofer was the Flyers' second-high scorer behind Clark. But the entire year went kaput with only 4 seconds left in the final game when a last-ditch goal doomed the Flyers to fifth place. The California Golden Seals were also struggling in the thick of the pack for the final playoff berth down to the last week, but had to settle for sixth. However, the Golden Seals unveiled 22-year-old rookie goaltender Gilles Meloche, and he showed why California is well protected in goal for years to come. The Seals' defense was also bolstered by newcomers Bob Stewart and Rick Smith, obtained from Boston in the trade for Carol Vatney. Stewart and Smith added much-needed muscle to the California lineup. Dick Redmond was the Seals' outstanding performer in his first full season in the NHL. Redmond is one of the best attacking defensemen to enter the league since Bobby Orr. His 45 points in 1972 gives testimony to that fact. The Los Angeles Kings were the fifth team gamely battling it out for the playoffs until the closing week. Whitey Veeding led all Kings scorers with 27 goals and 28 assists, his second big season in a row. The goaltending duo of Rogie Vachon and Gary Edwards had a busy year, and their presence, along with defenseman Gilles Marotte, has the Los Angeles defensive prospects looking up. The Kings had 5 players over the 20-goal mark: Ralph Backstrom, Butch Goring, Serge Bernier, and Jim Johnson, plus Veeding. Several more good reasons why the Kings are on the upgrade.